Hello friends, today we are going to understand one of the important topic in research methodology, that is types of hypothesis. First of all, let us understand meaning of hypothesis. A hypothesis is about assuming an idea before the commencement of research, but that idea must be proven or disproven during the research process using various scientific methods. A hypothesis and a prediction can be the same, but the term hypothesis is associated with careful calculations and educational guesses. The most common type of hypothesis are simple hypothesis, complex hypothesis, empirical hypothesis, null hypothesis, alternative hypothesis, logical hypothesis, and statistical hypothesis. So now let us understand each hypothesis in detail. Number 1. Simple hypothesis. A simple hypothesis is also called a basic hypothesis. It is defined as the relationship between two variables, an independent variable otherwise known as cause and a dependent variable otherwise known as effect. For example, providing two off day in a week, that is independent variable, can increase the work efficiency of the employee, that is dependent variable. Another example is getting at least 8 hours of sleep can make people more alert. Number 2. Complex hypothesis. A complex hypothesis describes a relationship between variables. However, it is a relationship between two or more independent variables and two or more dependent variables. For example, adults who drink sugar beverages on a daily basis and have a family history of health issues are more likely to become overweight and develop diabetes or other health issues. Another example, individuals that smoke cigarettes and live in large cities are more likely than others to have respiratory problem and an increased risk of cancer. Number 3. Empirical hypothesis. An empirical hypothesis is also termed as working hypothesis. These hypotheses take place when an idea or a theory become valid by undergoing various tests and observation. The final result of such test after overcoming different trial and error processes can be proven over time. For example, offering holiday trip to your employees are better than bonuses. Another example, women taking vitamin E grow hair faster than those taking vitamin K. Number 4. Null hypothesis. A null hypothesis denoted by HO proposes that two factors or groups are unrelated and that there is no difference between certain characteristics of a population or process. You must test the likelihood of the null hypothesis in tandem with an alternative hypothesis in order to disprove or discredit it. For example, there is no significant change in an individual work habit whether they get 8 hours or 9 hours of sleep. Another example, there is no significant change in the growth of a plant if one uses distilled water only or vitamin-rich water only to water it. Number 5. Alternative hypothesis. An alternative hypothesis denoted by H1 or HA is a claim that is contradictory to the null hypothesis. Researcher will pair the alternative hypothesis with the null hypothesis in order to prove that there is no relation. If the null hypothesis is disproven, then the alternative hypothesis will be accepted. If the null hypothesis is not rejected, then the alternative hypothesis will not be accepted. For example, customers' interest increases when you offer a gift with a product, as opposed to the product only. Another example, a person's health improves during the time when they drink green tea only, as opposed to root beer only. Number 6. Logical hypothesis. A logical hypothesis is a proposed explanation using limited evidence. Generally, you want to turn a logical hypothesis into an empirical hypothesis, putting your theories or postulations to the test. In reference to these examples, there is currently no evidence to support these hypotheses. However, you can form a hypothesis based on the data available to draw a logical conclusion. For example, cacti experience more successful growth rate than tulip on Mars. Number 7. Statistical hypothesis. A statistical hypothesis is an examination of a portion of a population or statistical model. In this type of analysis, you use statistical information from an area. For example, if you wanted to conduct a study on the life expectancy of people from India, you would want to examine every single resident of India. This is not practical. Therefore, you would conduct your research using a statistical hypothesis or a sample of India's population. So friends, these are the total type of hypotheses in my video. I hope my video helps you to understand all types. Thank you for watching my video.